So one of the very important argument atheists give about God is, okay, you say God exists, I will also believe God exists, provided if you show me God. So meaning, seeing is believing. If I can't see, I don't believe it. So my question is, how many of you have seen Poland? How many of you have seen Antarctica, Atlanta, all these countries, some small countries? So you have not seen. Do you believe it? As per your logic, you should not believe it, because you say only if I see, I believe. So you have not seen Poland. Does that mean Poland doesn't exist? You have not seen God. Does that mean God doesn't exist? Is the question. So now, even in our life, in our practical day-to-day life, we see so many things, but we don't believe it. For example, if you see yourself in a convex or a concave mirror, you appear either small or big. Do you believe it? We don't believe it. So in the physics, the theory of refraction, you put a stick in the water, it appears bent. Do you believe the stick is bent? No. But you are seeing it. Why can't you believe it? So there are so many things we see, we don't believe, and there are so many things which we don't see, but we believe. So then this argument, we cannot use it to understand the absolute person or God. So now, why by pratyaksha praman, we can't get the absolute knowledge? We cannot understand the absolute truth through our blunt material senses because of the following reasons. What are the reasons? We have four defects. All of us have to suffer or struggle or live our life with these four defects. These defects are connected to our senses. And what are these four defects connected to our senses? Number one, our senses are imperfect. Number two, our senses have a tendency to be illusioned. Number three, because there is a tendency to get illusion, there is a tendency to commit mistake. And number four, because we commit mistake, to just patch it up, there is a tendency to cheat. So what are the four defects all of us we have? Number one, senses, imperfect senses, tendency to get illusioned. Number three, tendency to commit mistake. And number four, cheating propensity, tendency to cheat. So these are the four mistakes. We will analyze one by one by one. So the first imperfection. So imperfect senses. How can you say our senses are imperfect? Because we can't see what is happening behind this wall. There is a wall and I can see only things which are inside the wall. Outside the wall, beyond the wall, we can't see. So our eyes are blind outside the range of 400 to 700 millimicrons. In this image you can see, what we can see is only those things which comes in that visible range. Those rays which comes outside this visible range, we can't see it. For example, radio waves, X-rays, ultraviolet rays, we can't see these things because it doesn't come under the visible range of vision. So because of that, we can't see that. Now, somebody may say, yes, I can't see something which is beyond in the solar system or whatever. But scientists say, you use this special microscope or a telescope or some special instrument, because our senses are imperfect, but the instrument which we have invented, it has better capacity. It can capture images which your eyes cannot capture. So one scientist actually said this. Another scientist actually made a comment saying that even though you have better instrument to capture things which you can't see, but still those captured images from that instrument, you have to see it through your own eyes. And again, you have to see and decide based on your own senses. But our senses are imperfect.